today, in my previous posts, I asked you to watch out for my new series coming up, STDs. Okay, so today we are going to talk about STDs, but we're not going to talk about a whole lot because there are plenty of them. Believe me, we can't exhaust them if we just continue. Yeah, so we'll just talk about one very popular one known as what? Gonorrhea. Yeah, so I got to understand during this whole lockdown time, a lot of people have been mingling. Even if you've not been going out, probably you've gotten one or two from somewhere, from some private hookups or whatever it might be. You've just gotten something and probably you're too shy to go to the hospital. Like for the men, it's pretty much the most talked about STD, okay? But it's not like what you hear from those at the roadside. They are shouting, oh, come and look at gonorrhea, or come and see gonorrhea. Don't do that. Stop it. Okay? Let's stop patronizing all these herbal things, especially those that are uneducated. Mind you, I never said using herbs is wrong, but what I'm trying to say is those ones you know that are not educated, they can't express themselves, they don't have appropriate machines or tools. The human body is not something you just pick up one concoction, mix up together, and then you administer. And then when they say, come and taste this, come and see this, people are standing around watching them. Even those that are educated and coming home from work. I see this every day and I just get pissed. I get angry. What's the meaning of all this? Are we not growing in this nation? Don't we think anything more for our health? Anyway, let's get back to what we are talking about. So gonorrhea is an STI, sexually transmitted infection. You can refer to it as an STD caused by a bacteria known as Neisseria gonorrhea. Okay, that's medical jargon. Okay, you don't need to care about that, but you should know it's an STI. So it is mainly passed on from one person to another through sexual contact. Yeah, you can get it from oral sex, vaginal sex, anal sex. So for those of us that like these three basic types, be careful, you can get it from that area. Yes, and for people who do not believe that if someone is infected with such a disease, if you go having oral sex with that person, I'm sorry for you, because you are in deep soup and you will get throat cancer, which manifests from sore throat. Okay, so especially normally now, people will say, how will I know the person has this particular type of disease? Well, you don't need to know if the person has it or not. All you need to do is to ensure that you're using a barrier method, a method of protection, something you can use to protect yourself. Don't go in bare. Somebody once told me, I feel like when you have sex without you, when you're using condom, it's like a baby licking sweets with the wrapper on it. Are you serious? This is your life we're talking about. This is your well-being we're talking about. So I demand that you take it seriously. Okay? Alright, so let's move forward. Now, we're talking about the symptoms, okay? So symptoms of gonorrhea. For men, sore throat, pain in the testicles. You can also have pain in the rectum, that is the anus. There's a rubber there, okay? So when you're having pain in that area, it's a sign. Burning, urination, swelling of the glands, penis, that is the tip of your penis where you have the most arousal if somebody touches you, okay? Alright, so you can also have something, a discharge like pus that may be colored yellow, green, or even gray color. Okay, now let me warn you, men are always or sometimes asymptomatic. When I say asymptomatic, it means they do not show signs, they do not show symptoms, but they have this thing inside of them and it keeps growing. It keeps growing until it causes a very long-term big problem. Now for the women, let's go to symptoms for the women. These women could also have discharges, yellow, whitish, milkish color. Sometimes a streak of green. When you're your notice a change in your menstrual period, you're overly pouring out blood, you know, and maybe just a drop, you're just spotting now, you're not having any serious menstrual flow, every month you just spot, please, you need to see a doctor. Pain while you're urinating is also a sign. So women are more symptomatic than men. Within 4 to 12 weeks, a woman will know that she has a disease or there is some abnormality in her body. Okay, for the men, he will never know. Now, the women are very open people. They easily contact anything, but the men are closed. That is why women, you need to be careful and take care of yourself. Now, if you have an untreated STDs, these are the complications it can cause in the future. I'm talking for both men and women now, but for the men, it can mainly cause infertility. That is, your sperm count will be low, or your sperm cells will not be motile anymore. Okay, then for the women now, you could actually have, it will block your fallopian tubes, or it will scar your fallopian tubes, and then it will result in ectopic pregnancy. When we say ectopic, not utopian, okay? Ectopic pregnancy, it means the pregnancy begins to grow outside of the fallopian tube. Now, it is supposed to move from the fallopian tube into the womb, okay? So that is how pregnancy functions. But when it leaves the fallopian tubes and begins to grow somewhere else, we call it an ectopic pregnancy. Such pregnancy can endanger the life of the mother and the child. Okay, it can also cause blindness for some fetus. If you manage to get pregnant in such situation and you're in the process of giving birth to the child, the baby will pass through the birth canal and such infection is there, the baby will be at risk of going blind. So please, let's be careful, let's be watchful. Okay, once you notice any of these abnormalities in your body, please kindly contact the doctor close to you. Don't be shy. Consultation will not take you much. It's better to save your life than to suffer something that will result in something else. Okay, all right, so that will be the end of our topic for today, gonorrhea. If you want to find out more, if you have questions, please contact me. Follow me on my Instagram page at Cute Health Tips. Follow me on Twitter at Cute Health Tips. You can also find me on Facebook, Bachiamaka. Okay, I'm always open. If you don't think you can go to the hospital, you can also consult me online by sending me a DM. I appreciate you so much. God bless you, wonderful people.